One of these stars is sitting in the secret square, and the contestant who picks it first could win a prize package worth over $4,500. Which star is it? Jim Nabors, Pearl Bailey, Oscar, Pam Grier, George Gobel, Arthur Godfrey, John Davidson, Karen Valentine, or Paul Lynde, all in the Hollywood Square. And here is the master of the Hollywood Squares, Peter Martin.
Thank you. Good evening. Welcome to the Hollywood Squares. Hello, stars. Hello, Oscar. Oscar, how's your life?
Well, it's absolutely miserable.
Oh.
But I like being miserable. That makes me happy.
It does.
But I don't like being happy, so that makes me miserable.
I want you to meet our two players for this evening. First of all, this is Paula Gutley to my left. Nice to have you with us, Paula.
Thank you.
Paula is a kindergarten teacher who types legal papers for her husband. Paula's other hobby is speaking Polish to her parents. And what nationality are they?
German.
German.
No, I'm an illiterate Polack.
An illiterate?
I can speak Polish, but I never learned to read or write it.
Oh, really?
It came in handy a lot.
Oh, you'll get a lot of letters just because of what you said.
But it's true. I'm really literate.
All right. Good luck this evening.
Thank you.
Sam DeAngelo. Nice to see you. Sam, welcome to our show. Sam is retired 1 month from the United States Marine Corps, but made that easy transition from Marine pilot to life insurance agent. True?
Yes, sir.
I don't see the correlation, but good luck this evening. We have a commercial. We'll be right back. Object for the players is to get three stars in a row, either across or but not a diagonally. It is up to them to figure out if a star is giving a correct answer or making one up. That's how they get the squares. Each completed game is worth $250. In addition, in the first three games, our players vie for that secret square. Ken?
And circle starts the first secret square for a trip to Hawaii. We'll jet you from Los Angeles to the Ala Moana Hotel at the entrance to Waikiki. 9 exotic restaurants and lounges, Polynesian entertainment pool, furnished by Americana Hotels. And you'll fly to Hawaii via Pan American World Airways with more 747s from the U.S. to more places in the world than any other airline. Pan Am, America's airline to the world. Take along a $500 assortment of dittos, tops, and jeans. You'll feel the fit because every pair is hand-measured. Side saddle pants, high-rises, pre-war denims, furnished by dittos. Plus, from across the Pacific, Hawaiian Tropic dark tanning oils and lotions, tanning research lab, 6 steps to the safest tan. Also, a unique design combined with quality diamonds is this 14-karat gold apple pendant furnished by Mastercraft Ring Company of Seattle and valued at over $300. And Eumig 30 XL Super 8 millimeter sound movie camera and 810 HQS sound projector for high-quality sound with all your motion pictures. Sound motion picture equipment furnished by Eumig. Plus a $2,300 sailboat and trailer, the Guppy 13, designed for family fun, handles easily, cabin sleep through, with cockpit storage compartment, self-righting features, complete with custom-designed Guppy trailer, furnished by Mellon Marine. That's it, Peter.
All right, Ken, let's show the whole audience the secret square. As you know, the stars are brief before the show to help them with their bluffs, but they're hearing the actual questions for the first time. Paula, my dear, you won the toss. Good luck. Pick a star.
Thank you. Since my name is Paula, I've got to go with Paul Lynde.
All right. Paul, was Snow White a blonde or a brunette? Snow White. Was she a blonde or a brunette?
Only Walt Disney knew for sure.
I remember a very, very brunette.
Brunette.
Yes, I agree.
Absolutely. Good start. Okay, Sam, your turn.
Roger, I'll go with the Marine, Jim Nabors.
Okay. Jim, if you rub one artichoke against another and you hear a squeak, what does that mean?
I never have rubbed them, so I just have to guess. Probably means they're ruined.
They're not ruined.
I disagree.
No, they're fresh. Yeah. Okay, put an X there. All right, Paula, your turn.
John Davidson, please.
John, what great author wrote under the name of James Whitcomb Riley?
I've never read that book, Peter.
Oh, under the name of... Oh, I see. James Whitcomb Riley.
Yes. Who wrote under that name?
You cannot trick me on Nighttime Hollywood Square. Trust me, it was James Whitcomb Riley. That is his real name.
Paula?
I disagree.
He wrote under the name of James Whitcomb Riley. James Whitcomb Riley. That's why he wrote under that name. Put an X there, Sam.
Going with Oscar.
All right. And that's the secret square. I thought you might go with Karen and buy the next star. Oscar. Oscar, are you okay?
Yeah. I was afraid you'd choose me.
This question is worth $4,600. Are you intimidated?
Slightly.
Listen now carefully, all right? Who was the youngest performer ever to win an Academy Award for acting? For acting, was it Patty Duke, Shirley Temple, or Tatum O'Neill? The youngest performer ever to win an Academy Award for acting? Patty Duke, Shirley Temple, or Tatum O'Neill?
Oh, what was that? Oh, I got the question. Yeah. That's not very funny. I mean, that's not a funny question.
You know? No, well, it's not supposed to be. It's worth... It's a very serious question.
Yeah,
$4,600.
Well, all right. Okay. I think it's Potato O'Neill.
No. Tatum. He says Tatum O'Neill.
I agree.
You agree with a grouch?
I agree.
He's right, and you are correct. Oscar, you've made a man very, very happy. You should be proud.
I'm sorry to hear that. I don't like that.
Say, Sam, you've got that Hawaiian vacation and the jeans, the jewelry, a movie camera outfit, the sailboat worth $4,600. Congratulations, and we'll buy for another Super Square next game. Okay, Paula, your turn.
Okay, Karen Valentine, please.
Karen, true or false, having a good memory is a sign of a well-adjusted personality.
What was the question?
Having a good memory is a sign of a well-adjusted personality.
Yes, it is.
I would tend to agree.
No.
No.
Oh.
In fact, listen, psychotics tend to have much better memories than normal people. The way we were. Can't put it next there, Sam.
Pearl Bailey, please.
All right. Pearly Mae, this is for $250. True or false? Muhammad Ali's Muhammad Ali's great-grandfather.
Peter, I suggest you get this right. You know him.
Every time I see Muhammad Ali, I'm intimidated. Yeah. Muhammad Ali's great-grandfather was an Irishman named Grady. True or false?
Well, they're pretty tough. And no doubt about him. Great-great-grandfather.
Great-grandfather.
Oh, yes.
She said yes.
I agree.
That's right. According to the celebrity register, you got yourself $250. We're going to have a commercial. We'll return and play another Secret Square game right after this. This Secret Square game is worth about $3,500.
And this time, Egg starts a Secret Square for the Ultimate Cooking Center. A Litton double oven microwave range. Microwave speed, self-cleaning oven, one-piece smooth top. Advanced features include a digital timer, smokeless broiling, automatic oven timer, furnished by Litton. And Sous-Vide Spun Cream Honey, the soft spreadable honey in the reusable plastic table server. Sous-Vide Spun Cream Honey, the delicious pure honey spread. Plus, John Hancock's Fiesta, genuine California redwood, designed with beauty, built for durability. This weather-resistant collection brings elegance and comfort to indoor and outdoor living. Fiesta, furnished by John Hancock Furniture. Also, a gift certificate for $1,000 worth of steaks, furnished by Bonanza Family Restaurants, with over 600 locations coast to coast, featuring a wide variety of family-priced meals from the Bonanza Buffet. And soft, chewy, delicious Twizzlers in a variety of fun-to-eat flavors, strawberry, licorice, chocolate, and grape. Twizzlers, the family favorite anytime. Enjoy a 25-inch color television set from True Value Hardware Stores. You combine value and personal service in over 5,000 locations. A color console furnished by True Value Hardware. Okay, Peter.
Okay, Kenny, let's show the home audience to Secret Square, and San Diego will start this game.
Jim Nabors, please.
Jim, according to author Desmond Morris in the book Intimate Behavior, unlike you, the Pope normally uses both arms when he does something. When he does what?
Embraces you?
Embraces.
I agree.
No, waves. Waves. Okay, put a circle there. Paula, a break for you.
Oh, good. Oscar, we watch him all the time. I just love him.
That's the secret spell again. Oscar, aren't you excited? You're the secret square again.
You tricked me.
Now, this one's worth $3,500. Listen carefully, all right? Who was the first West Point graduate to become president of the United States? Was it Ulysses S. Grant, Theodore Roosevelt, or Dwight Eisenhower? The first West Point graduate to become president. Grant, Theodore Roosevelt, or Dwight Eisenhower?
Um, General Grant.
General Grant. Yeah.
Yes, I agree.
That's right. Yay! Okay, you've got the microwave range, the redwood furniture, $1,000 worth of steaks, a color TV, $3,500. Oscar, aren't you proud again? You've made a woman happy. You're not happy.
I'm not supposed to help people.
Okay, back to the car. Sam?
Fairly, please.
Fairly, May. Does exercise really turn fat into muscle, yes or no?
Fat into muscle?
Exercise.
Exercise turn fat into muscle. Does exercise makes the fat into muscle. Turn
yes
into
no?
muscle, yes.
I disagree.
Oh, yeah. When an untrained person exercises, in fact, he tends to replace lost fat with muscle.
Yeah,
right, okay. You can't put a circle there, Paula. You'll have to earn that yourself.
Okay, Pearl.
For a tie game, has Da Vinci's The Last Supper ever been exhibited in America, Pearl?
Has
it ever been exhibited here in the United States?
In the United States.
The Last Supper, Da Vinci's.
The Last Supper. I know they brought that Pietro over here, but The Last Supper. I don't remember them moving
that. She said no.
I don't remember that either.
You know why? It's painted on the wall of a condo in Milan. Yes, okay. We've got a tie game. That's nice. Circle gets a square. Okay, Secret Square game number 3, and Kenny Williams will tell us about it.
And Circle stars the Secret Square 4. Roy Hill's traditional design bedroom crafted of oak solids and veneers, clean, timeless styling, finished in warm brown tones, highlighted by distinctive brass hardware, furnished by Roy Hill. And Tastemaker introduces their new design collection of Marlene with sheets, pillowcases, and towels. Tastemaker can design needed for the American home, plus an 18-pound capacity Washmaster automatic wash with 5 wash and 5 rinse temperatures, plus Gibson's edgy-soaked action. Gets more work done in less time in a matching Drymaster dryer with vacuum-dry system that dries clothes faster, yet is more gentle to fabrics, furnished by Gibson. And enjoy Radio Shack's outstanding AM and FM stereo sound records and 8-track tapes with this complete realistic music system furnished by Radio Shack, a Tandy Corporation company, and a library of Bantam Books bestsellers, including the illustrated encyclopedia Rules of the Game, autographed by Olympic gold medalist Bill Toomey. Bestseller furnished by Bantam Books. Okay, Peter.
Okay, Kenny, let's show the whole audience the Secret Square. Paula said that a lot of her students, the Vietnamese students that she's had, have learned English from listening to Big Bird and Oscar on Sesame Street. You should be proud.
Yes.
Paula?
I'd like to start with Arthur Godfrey.
Arthur Godfrey. According to experts, is there any reason to X-ray a tuba? Yes or no? Any reason at all to X-ray a tuba?
To X-ray a tuba?
Mm-hmm. Yes or no?
You wanted to find some cracks in it? Yes.
Paula?
Yes, I would agree.
It's commonly done to see why they are playing off-key. That is why. Yes, okay, with a circle. Sam?
Jim Nabors, please.
Jim, is there a higher suicide rate for chickens in dry weather?
I ought to know that. I raised enough chickens. Suicide rate.
In dry weather, is there a higher suicide rate for chickens in dry weather?
Well, first of all, I never did know chickens committed suicide, but I would say it would have to say no.
I disagree.
They tend to drown themselves in watering tanks during dry weather. Yes, okay, you've got the X. We've got a commercial word. We'll be back. Secret Square game. Paula?
Okay, I'd like to start with George Gobel.
All righty. George, recently...
It's clean.
How about Bobby Vinton?
Yeah, that's where I learned it.
Yes, really? Recently, a man made headlines because his fiance had shot him 3 times in the past 16 months. That's true. Now, what we want to know is, did he go through with the wedding?
Yeah, but they had to tape the wedding band to his forehead. Yes, he did.
He said they went through with it.
With the gun in my back, I guess I would too. Yes, I agree.
He called it off from his hospital bed. Put an X there. Sam?
Paul Lynde.
All righty. Paul, for $500, true or false, they use cow's horns to make ice cream.
You mean those weren't chocolate chips?
Yes.
Boy, I tell you. I there's so much preservatives in ice cream. You know, you cannot melt ice cream in your with water running on it. There's that many. I would say probably true.
I agree.
Gelatin is made from the horns, which is then used to make the ice cream. $500, Sam DeAngelo. Congratulations. Did you go to Oscar again? No, I was carrying Valentine this time. So it's the race for the car, and Sam DeAngelo pick a star.
I'll take Arthur Godfrey.
Arthur, in 1949, at age 71, someone named Alban Barkley became the oldest American to do something. To do what?
In what year, please, sir?
At 49, at age 71, Alban Barkley became the oldest American to do something. Do what?
Vice President of the United States.
I agree with Arthur Godfrey.
That's right. I believe it was under Truman. I'm not sure, but I believe so. Okay, with the X, Paula, your turn.
I'd like to go with Jim Nabors.
Jim, your opponent has just hit a blot. Blot. And the man hit is removed from the table and placed on the bar. What game are you playing?
It's the new game. I don't play it too good.
I don't believe Jim can pick up the game. I know, but would you like the question, Paula?
No.
I know what.
You think it? No, it's too late. You say it's backgammon. You would have been correct. Backgammon. That's all right. Back to a Jim Nabors question. True or false? According to the Chicago Tribune, the acting governor of Samoa claims the highlight of his day is watching Hollywood Squares after a hard day's work. The governor of Samoa. Is that true? Does he watch the Hollywood Squares, his favorite game?
Samoa?
Mm-hmm.
Is that around here? I don't know. It's a very popular show, so I'd say yes.
I would hope so.
Well, if he didn't, we wouldn't have had this question on the show, I think. Yeah. Along with sharing dinner with his wife, that's true. Good for you, folks in Samoa. What a specialist. Sam, your
George
turn.
Gobel, please.
George, their motto is, we learn by doing. Who are they?
The Costa Rican Commercial Pilots Association. That's the Campfire Girls.
The Campfire Girls.
I agree.
Nope, the 4-H Clubs. Put a circle there. Your turn, Paula.
Paul, again.
For $500 in the tie game, true or false, every day, about 10 million American women take the pill.
And I can name them all.
Hello.
I can't stay.
But do 10 million American women take that pill?
Yes.
Yes, oh yes.
And you know something? 50 million worldwide. We have a tie game. That's good. Circle gets the square. Let's play the board. Paula Gutley, pick a star.
Paul Lynde.
Paul, true or false, research indicates that Christopher Columbus liked to wear bloomers and long stockings.
No, well, it's not easy to sign a crew up for 6 months.
Did old Chris like to wear bloomers?
Yes, he always had them on when I saw his picture.
Paula?
Yes, I agree.
Sure, a lot of guys did then. All right, with the circles there.
Jim Nabors.
Jim, we've all heard of Schubert's famous unfinished symphony. Did he plan to finish it, yes or no?
No.
I disagree.
Oh, yeah. 9 bars of the third movement were finished, and the rest had been sketched out. With an X. Okay, Paula, pick a star. Early May. True or false, the pine trees had to be removed from George Washington's chest on Mount Rushmore. 2 pine trees had to be removed from George Washington's chest on Mount Rushmore. True or false?
From his chest?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know his chest was there. I know his head is up there. And then they went on.
No.
Let me clarify what that is, and it's very, very important. I'll tell you why, but let me just review the whole thing. That is our buzzer. That means the time is up. So this question is worth more than an X or a circle. It's worth our brand new automobile. So I'm going to repeat the question to you, Pearlie Mae.
Yes.
Audience?
Yes.
Be quiet. Pearlie, true or false? 2 pine trees had to be removed from George Washington's chest on Mount Rushmore. True or false?
No, only the heads are there.
She said that is false.
I think that because there's shrubbery growing from the rock, I would think that they may have removed real pine tree. So,
so you disagree?
Disagree.
It is true, or you've won it yourself
true.
A car. Circle gets a square.
It's not Marilyn Monroe, it's Motormouth.
Motormouth. Well, I'm going to add up Sam's scores over here. You've got $550 in cash, and you won a $4,600 secret square. So it's over a $5,000 evening for Sam DeAngelo. Congratulations to you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Retired Marine is now an insurance agent. And Paula, you've got $600 in cash. You won a secret square, $3,500. You've won the following. Kenny.
It's Pontiac's Mark II subcompact Astra, distinctive title with responsive four-cylinder engine, electronic ignition, overhead cam, three-speed floor shift, furnished by Pontiac.
We did not chat with Pam Grier this evening, but next time out, we will, Pam. Thank you, stars. Congratulations to the players. Have a good evening. See you here next time on the Hollywood Square.
This has been a Merrill Heater Bob Quigley production.